What's up, YouTube? It's Adam from I'm a Music Mogul, and today I'm going to show you how to do fades in Logic. I've been getting a lot of emails, a lot of questions saying that people can do it very easily in GarageBand, but how do they do it in Logic? And well, it's equally as easy as it is in GarageBand to do it in Logic, so I'm going to show you right now how to do it. Basically, actually, let's play the audio loop here first. Alright, simple enough, right? Alright, so let's say I want to fade in the beginning and fade out the end. So here's how you do it. You hit the escape on your keyboard. Very easy. I love that tool. All your tools are right there when you hit escape on your keyboard. Go to the crossfade tool. Click and drag just in front of the audio loop and drag a little bit on top. And there's your fade right there. You can change the curve of the fade. So it could go like that. You can make it a little faster and go like that. Faster in. A slower in time. And also, you can make the fade bigger, so you can build it up. And that's what you could do in different styles of genres of music, is a build up with a fade. And let's say I want to fade in the end. Again, hit your escape tool, go to crossfade tool, click and drag in the area just outside of the loop, and drag inside. Drag as far as you want to go. Let's say I want to go there. It gives you a linear line if you want to make a curve. Do whatever you want, just click and drag on the curve. Or you can make it bigger and smaller by going on this line right here. Now let's play the loop and hear how it sounds with our fades. Alright, so there's our fades. Now let's say we want to fade in or crossfade between two audio files. Let's show you how to do it right now. Just undoing all my fades here. Perfect. Let me bring in my other audio loop. I will bring it aside here. Okay, so when your audio loops are beside each other, all you have to do again, hit escape, go to your crossfade tool, click and drag on both of the audio files, and then you get a crossfade right there. Let me zoom in so you could get a better look. And again, you can change your crossfade size, length, and whatever you want else, you can change the curve. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna show you, it's very useful to apply to any track that you have, any vocals, any instrumentals, any guitars, whatever it is. If you cut an audio in a certain spot, so let's play the audio first so we hear how it sounds in its entirety. All right, so that's the loop in its entirety. Now I'm going to just cut it in a few places as if you would any vocals, any instrumentals. I'm going to cut in random places just to show you what it is, but you'll be more fine-tooth and comb. But I just want to show you how it sounds when you don't add in a fade at the beginning and end of your loops when you chop it up. So I'm just going to cut out a spot there. Delete there. I'll cut out one more spot just to show you a second time around. All right. So now I cut out two spots. Now take a listen to the audio. You might hear some clicks at the end of each audio file. All right. It did sound very choppy and not very good. All right. So let's just say that we add in a crossfade in and a crossfade out. So let's put a fade out here. Just a little one. You don't need a lot. And you want to do it as slow. Let me zoom in here. The key here is not to do a very long fade, but to do a very quick fade. Just so you take out those clicks and pops. Like you can even go as small as that. Now let's take a listen to the audio file and we will see how it sounds. Probably a lot better. All All right, so that's a cool little tip for all you guys who chop out audio, chopping audio out there, and especially you should apply this to every vocal edits that you do. So usually in vocal edits, you cut out the dead air in between phrases. So you cut out the dead space, and then it comes in with the vocals. You should always, always, always put crossfades at the beginning and end of each audio region that you cut up, because this way you don't get clicks or pops or anything like that. It's going to be nice, clean, and that is a good mixing tip that you guys should always take and use and apply when you are mixing. So that's it for the fades and logic. All right, guys. Again, any more questions, write to me. I will try and make a video on it. Take care, guys. I'm Adam from iMusicMogul. Remember to subscribe and check out the website, www.iMusicMogul.com. All right, guys. Later. Class is now out of session.